Hey everyone, today we're unboxing mid-tier budget graphics card from Nvidia, EVGA 1660. And we're giving you 5 reasons to buy it, or not to buy it if you're on the red team. Go.
Let's open this bad boy. Okay.
Well, packaging for this thing is the next level. We started with bubble wrap, cushion, and anti-static wrapping. This is it. EVGA 1660. Peel time. Alrighty, let's look at the card. Oh, wait, peel time again. We have a couple of covers. One is for PCIe Express and one for IO Shroud mounting point. They're being extra careful with this card. Feels premium. Let's talk about the card. Well, first of all, the size. Let me tell you, size matters. Zotac 1660 Ti, EVGA 1660. Look at the size. This one is faster. Do not fall. 8-pin power connector. Dual fan design. 3 heat pipes for optimized heat dissipation. It's not very tall, it's very long, not very tall. Display port, HDMI port, and DVI port. You guys still use DVI ports? No fancy LEDs? That's okay, it's okay, it's okay.
Not.
Nvidia surprised us with the release of 16 series. I mean, we heard rumors about non-RTX lineup, but personally I wasn't advocate of the idea of them just rebranding 10 series. Just like AMD did back in the day when they rebranded RX 400 to RX 500. Yes, RX 480 and 580 are the same, I don't care what you say. Nvidia 10 series was based on Pascal architecture, which was a hit mostly thanks to crypto mining, of course. Since GTX 1080 came out, I thought this is it. 4K gaming is here to stay. Well, we dialed down settings, but you know. Then they released 1080 Ti and dropped the prices on 1080 cards. Even better. 1060, 1070 were selling like hotcakes. It doesn't like hotcakes. 1080p gamers even enjoy 1050 cards. 1070 Ti was a bit of a confusion, but still pretty good. Anticipation that we will see a new generation of GPUs from Team Green was pretty high. Until one of the Nvidia vendors decided to return over 300,000 chips due to the fact that they predicted. I wonder why. Bitcoin. So this huge inventory pretty much delayed RTX release and got AMD all cozy about their releases. Not just that, a whole bunch of important people left AMD. Raj. So what we have now is overpriced RTX cards and nothing from AMD. We did get Radeon 7, but let's be honest. It's Vega 56 on steroids. They put it on 7 nanometer node and put more memory into it. When we benchmarked Radeon 7, we did not see any instructions per clock improvements. So basically, if you run Vega 56 and Radeon 7 at the same speed on not memory intensive applications, most games are memory intensive though, then you're not gonna see that much of a difference. And the video about that coming up soon. I know we're a little overdue. Apologies. Let's go back to Nvidia topic, shall we? Nvidia was left with a huge inventory of chips from previous generation, and that's why we see so many GTX 1060 variants. They could have dropped the price on more expensive cards, as they would be basically competing with themselves and lose when overpriced new generation of cards come out. So the only appropriate way to deal with overstock is to refresh most profitable, best-selling GeForce GTX 1060. Then we said bon voyage to previous Pascal architecture and all the mess associated with it. And moved on to Turing. right? Wrong. See, RTX doesn't really sell that well. People are confused why they have to pay extra for something they can't use. Things like RTX. DLSS, global illumination, ray tracing are just words at this point. But then GTX 1060 came out with GDDR5 memory, just like most of the cards from previous architecture. And you thought you moved on, new life, new beginning. Yet you're scared and confused. Start thinking how things used to be and questioning pretty much every decision you made in your life. For what? What is the purpose of this all? What are we talking about? Oh yeah, 5 reasons to buy GTX 1060. Reason number 1, the obvious, the price. You don't believe me? Let's look at the charts and see.
See what I mean?
Not only managed to deliver good results, it's also top card on FPS per dollar chart. In 1080p though, 1080p strictly. For budget 4040p build, we have Vega 6 and RTX 2060 roasting each other. Reason number 2, GDDR5. Hear me out. GDDR5 has tighter memory timings. In applications that are not optimized for GDDR6, GDDR5X, and HBM memory, you would love to take advantage of this ancient technology. While testing Apex Legends, GTX 1070 Ti with GDDR5 did better than GTX 1080 with GDDR5X for the money. So the takeaway here is the memory bandwidth is not everything. Radeon 7 has like 1 terabit of memory bandwidth. It could only take you so far. There's a whole bunch of other stuff needs to be taken care of, like optimization on game engine level and drivers and architecture and BIOS and just give us Navi, okay? Radeon 7. Reason number 3, it still is RTX. Well, sort of. 16 series is based on Turing, with a whole bunch of goodies disabled. I shouldn't have done that. They call it Turing Minor and Turing Major. I bet you can guess which one is which. Turing Minor retains adaptive shadowing technology, which is basically makes your video card focus all the power on what you see and render it well, then drop pixel quality on things that are not noticeable, like objects and shadows themselves. Pretty cool, huh? Only small problem, no one uses this technology except for Wolfenstein 2, but it's a cool little bonus anyway. Oh yeah, almost forgot. In April, Nvidia will be releasing new drivers that would enable ray tracing on 10 and 16 series cards. So we'll see some sort of traceable rays on non-RTX hardware, maybe, just maybe. Some optimization in the future from the software side? Who knows? But 16 series cards should do better than 10 series cards, thanks to reworked SM structure. Power! Efficiency. When compared to RX 570, the card runs very cool, and in return, it grants us with respectable clocks for you overclock junkies. and a couple of bucks from your electric bill. Number five, the drivers. Drivers. You buy an Nvidia card, the driver recovery while playing a game or trying to get that crazy score in 3D Mark, it's pretty amazing. While playing with Radeon 7, Vega 56, Vega 64, RX 570, RX 580, we straight up had to reboot the system sometimes, because we would get a hard lock in the game. It barely happens on Nvidia side. Drivers just don't die, even if you overclock it. It would still recover. AMD software has gotten so much better over the years. There's room for improvement though. GTX 1660 is a pretty good card. And if you haven't upgraded your budget build in a few years, you should consider buying this. Would you though? Leave us a comment below. If you're a fan of AMD products, what would it take to get you to switch to Nvidia? GTX 1660 for under 200 bucks maybe? Stay tuned for more 1660 content. This is George with George Tech. Subscribe for more. Bye. Out.